I am back home in Indiana. We're in Evansville, Indiana. We just crossed over the line. And this is typical what I remember of Indiana. Gray day. Not a lot of leaves on the tree yet. Kind of gloomy. But I kind of like it. But I'm ready to be at Shackleback State Park. I'm ready to set up camp. Have a cold one and relax for the night.
Well, we made it in super late last night. Super late. It was, it wasn't really all that late. It was about, 7 o'clock when we got here to Shackleback State Park. But it was dark and it was very dark in here. Not knowing where we were going in here was a little scary. So I ended up unhooking the Bronco, basically right over there, and driving over and finding our site in the Bronco, because it was, kind of hard to see where the numbers were. Like, you can see a number there, but on our site the number is way back on the post, back on the electrical post, way back by there, 310. So it was pretty hard to see that last night. It is definitely colder than what we are used to here, that's for sure. I had to go back in. I had to put on my new flannel shirt and get a stocking cap on, because it is pretty cold this morning. While Nikki and I are waiting on Allie to get ready and do her hair and makeup and all that stuff, we are fixing to head over to my family's and my grandpa's farm. This is where I will plan on scattering my dad's ashes. I'm hoping we can find it. They turned it into a nature preserve. When I was about 17, 18 years old, the state bought it from my grandpa and turned it into like a horseback riding, hunting nature preserve. So we're going to go try to locate that first, do that, revisit my childhood home. Today's going to be just a day of basically driving around, revisiting areas, just seeing how much things have changed since I moved, and how much things have changed in the 8 years since it's been since I've been home. This used to be a pizza place right here. We go in there and get pizza. The door to the left here used to be the arcade. We'd go in there and play Pac-Man. We spent a lot of quarters in this arcade right here. Can't tell you how many hours we spent waiting here at the chiropractic. Terry Passons, he was our chiropractor, family friend, but there was no appointments here. It was a first come, first serve, and people would line up in their cars out here waiting hours before he would show up for work just to try to be the first in.
He was that good, huh?
I guess so. And the window there into the office there is still, that's where you would pay.
Wow.
It's still there. Huh. Okay, so I guess we're done exploring Jasonville. That's really all there was here in Jasonville through my growing up years, was coming over here to go to the chiropractor. We are going to head back towards, probably towards my childhood home, and then on over to my grandpa's area and my grandpa's farm, and take care of that. It's a perfect day for this. Gray and depressing. This is Prairie Creek Park. This is actually where I would have loved to have camped out here, but they close, I think, end of October through the season. They do have a gate here, so let's take a drive back to the campground. But I've actually played baseball on this field over here, but a couple times.
Disc golf out here.
They do.
Mm-hmm.
Almost stepped on a water moccasin over here one time as a kid. That little lake or pond, whatever you want to call it. Boy, this is only a couple miles from my childhood home, and we would spend a lot of time here. And it says there, campground closed. That sucks. I mean, I would have been willing to boondock here and just live off the generator while we were here. But we'll take a look at the campground while we're here. this is a bucket list thing for me to come back and do when it is open. Problem is, with my job, it's going to be tough. I'm going to have to do it when I retire. So some things have changed here, I can tell you that right now. There used to be a, that's the dump station there, but there used to be a little bathhouse there too, or restrooms. So they built new restrooms up here, it looks like. And I can see, looks like a new building. And most of these sites look pretty small for our rig, but this one here looks good. We could definitely fit in that one right there. That's 11. And it's got electric. I don't know if it has water. I see water over here. These are pretty small. This is my home park right here, though. Never camped here, but we did come here a lot.
And this is it? This is all the spots they have right here?
Yeah, there's some more over on the other side. This is down at the boat launch, and it looks like part of this circle drive is now underwater. It looks a little dilapidated here, but we fished here a couple times. Not a lot. Never did any boating.
So right here at Prairie Creek, they have a maple syrup container here.
Sugar cabin.
Yep.
They call it.
So you can put jars underneath there and get maple syrup. Pretty cool.
So this is Wilson Field, and it's abandoned now. There's not even a road back in here. I'm just driving on the grass. It's all overgrown. Apparently they don't play baseball here anymore. Yeah, this was my baseball field from T-ball all the way up into Little League. And they've tore down the fencing, it looks like, for the second field back there. But most of my games were played right here on this field. And played there until, I don't know how old I was, and then I transferred to another town. I played for Shelburne, I played for Hudsonville. Concession stands up here. I can still remember going up there and you buy the fountain drink, the Coca-Cola. You get that, you know, that paper Coca-Cola cup, and oh my God, it tastes so good. You cannot beat the concession stand Coca-Cola of my youth flavor. It was awesome. That's the concession stand. Wow, it has really changed. These trees have gotten huge. We used to play football right out here, and there weren't all these trees. It looks like it's in, wow, they built a new barn. My dad built the red pole barn there. And the old barn back there, oh man, it's ready to fall over. Wow. The Pleasant Valley Church here, and this is where Lori and I would go to church as kids. My dad actually was one of the guys who built the steeple on the top.
The windows.
I think it doesn't look like it's in service anymore.
Wow.
This is the church that I went to as a kid. Went to Sunday school here, and like I was saying, my dad and some other members and families around here, they built this steeple, or rebuilt the steeple, and the bell at the top. And I believe they did some re-siding on it too. I know Dad was pretty instrumental in doing some work on some of these things around here, but I don't know if it's still in service or not. It looks like it could be, because there is, it's like they got vines decorated here for Christmas, so maybe it's still in service, but the windows are like broken. It looks like they're boarded up, so I don't know, but this is my childhood church.
Well, I'm taking Allie down to what we call the river bottoms, and she's never seen this. I haven't been here since I was a teenager living here. The times we came back before, we either was in a Mustang or we were in the Ford Escape. Not really a road conducive for those type of vehicles. So I thought, hey, we got the Bronco. Let's do it this time. And as we are pulling up to this bridge right here, I got to say, right here, okay, good story right here. There, well, actually, there was water in this ditch when we were here as teenagers. But right here is where I found my first beer. Somebody must have been fishing, and me and my buddy David was down here on our motorbikes, and we found a six-pack of Old Milwaukee beer sitting in the water here. So that's where I tasted my first beer. My first beer was an Old Milwaukee, and I was, I have to say, I was probably 15 or 16 at the time, at the most, so don't judge me. See that, what it looks like, a berm up there, or whatever you call it?
Uh-huh.
That's the river. That's to try to keep the river from overflowing its banks.
Huh. Man, we are literally driving right in the middle of a pasture.
We're driving right in the middle of a field.
Who thought we would come to Indiana here and do a little off-roading?
We got a little mud on the tires today.
Yeah, we've been basically just driving down in the river bottoms through fields along these roads. It's weird that this road actually has some pavement, old blacktop on it. So this must have been a road at one point, a real road. But this is just on the other side of this little man-made berm, or whatever you call it, is the Wabash River. And on the other side is Illinois. That's the Wabash River right there. The mighty Wabash. Look at that. It's flowing pretty good, too. So, other side's Illinois. This is the dividing line. Cool. What do you think?
Very cool.
What do you think, Nikki? Huh? You like it?
Very pretty.
Old schoolhouse. Still there. And that's an Indian burial mound behind it, back up in there.
My goodness.
Yep.
So the house is gone.
This was where my dad was born, and this was his house.
Wow.
House, all that remains is just a piece of the porch.
Wow. Huh. So sad. Back to the Chuck's grandfather's cabin to see if it's still here.
And there's the cabin. Oh, here's the barn up here. The barn's still there.
So this was the barn.
Yep.
You gonna get out and walk?
I can drive through there, I think.
Wow. Holy cow. Wow.
So I'm down by the river here near where my dad grew up, and this is a cabin that his grandpa built that I always loved. I always wanted to camp in his cabin, actually. Never got to. I even always thought that they had better furniture in the cabin than they did at their house. But I really wanted to see if it was still here. It's here, but it's in bad shape. I can definitely.
This is the barn. I can't believe all this is kind of still here, even though it's really in bad shape, obviously. This was my grandpa's. He would keep some farm tractors here.
Well, we are here at my grandpa's farm. The machine shop shed that used to be here, that sat right in front of those cropping of trees there, is gone. I mean, it was pretty dilapidated 8 years ago, so I'm not surprised they went ahead and tore it down.
We'll throw up a picture here to show what it looked like last time we were here.
Yeah, but we were able to positively ID it with the trees. And I knew that they had two porta potties there, and basically kind of in that area where the porta potties were is where my grandpa's big fuel tanks were for his tractors. We're gonna walk back this lane here. We're gonna walk back here. There's a couple of the big fields that he had was back here. And I'm kind of looking for this one particular spot that I think I want to kind of maybe scatter his ashes. I don't know if I can find it. You gotta remember, I was, you know, probably the last time I was way back in Eastfields, it was probably 12, 13, 14 years old. So a lot of time has passed. And there used to be a house too. I mean, my grandpa had built a house somewhere over in this area here. And one of his daughters lived on it. And I guess the house is obviously gone too. But I was pretty sure it was right next to the entrance here. But we might try to explore and see if we see any remnants of that while we're here. So these are two of the bigger fields that he had here. My grandpa had 130 acres, but I think if I remember correctly, he only had about 60 or 70 of that was tillable. So he had a lot of trees, you know, a lot of wooded areas.
Look how beautiful it is.
But this was one of the fields I remember. I remember soybeans in this field and corn. Absolutely brings back some memories for sure. And it's the second field over here. And we were here 8 years ago and Nikki was here. So this is Nikki's second time getting to see the family farm, isn't it, girl? You love it. Just be careful because there's hunters out here probably, because this is a nature preserve now for horseback riding and hunting and whatnot, fishing. So we're at the back edge of this field now. And I'm trying to remember where the lane was that went to the next field, which was a little ways away. There used to be a lane with a hill that would scare the crap out of me on the tractor. I would love to find that area and see that other field that's set back in there a little farther. We were walking back to go back to the Bronco after really not finding the lane that I wanted to find going to the other field. I'm looking through here and I see this, and all of a sudden the bells started going off in my head, and I told Allie, I said, this is the pond that we camped on, me and my dad and grandpa, and we did some fishing on. And if memory serves me correctly, we camped on that other side of the pond over there, but this is where I got poison ivy really bad on that camping trip. It was one of my first fishing experiences. This was a little man-made pond that my grandpa had made way back in the day. All right, so as we were walking back and I found the pond here where we camped as kids with my dad and grandpa. That was me, my grandpa, and my dad. And the time that I got poison ivy I was telling you about, we got to thinking this would probably be the perfect spot, honestly. It was a great memory for all of us, other than the fact that I got poison ivy.
Which you can look back at now and laugh about it.
Yeah, because there's a funny story about the poison ivy we'll tell you later. I don't want to really get into funny stuff right now, but I figure, you know, we were tent camping here. It was my first experience tent camping. Obviously, we love camping now. This is probably where it all began. This was my first time fishing. So we're going to put my dad to rest here. So I think this is actually around the spot where we camped. It looks very, very familiar to me. And when I got the poison ivy, it was because I leaned against a tree when I was going to the bathroom. And I got it on my hands. And I ended up getting it on my, well, you can probably figure it out, but yeah. Could have been one of these trees for all we know. It looks like there's vines growing on these trees, and I don't know if that's poison ivy or not, but I'm not gonna touch it and find out.
Well, we are off for day two of exploring Indiana.
I think we're going to, first thing I want to do is go by my old schools, which would be my high school in North Central, and then maybe pimento, see if it's still there. And because the last time that we were there, they had torn down one of the buildings. There was two buildings, and I think they've torn them both down now. And I want to see that, and I want to see my old elementary school of Hoosier Prairie. Here at my old high school, North Central. This is all new. This was never here before. So, it's a memorial here. And I don't remember this part of the building being here either. Seems new. I guess they built it in 2002. That's what I'm gonna say. The junior and senior high school, all in one. This is where the buses would pull up, drop us off. We'd go in these doors here. Yep. Used to drive myself to school too the last couple years and park out here in the parking lot. This is our football field over here and track field. Looks the same. Everything still looks the same there. I ran around that track lap a few times. Not that I was a track person, but they made us do it in gym class some. But went to several homecoming games there. Our football team was terrible. The whole 4 years of my high school career here, we won only one game. We were not good. And I wasn't able to play football because my mom wouldn't let me. She's afraid I'd get hurt. Only sport I didn't get to play. And there's the baseball field where I started to play baseball here, but I ended up getting cut because I discovered girls and I skipped practice one day to go out with a girl. And I was cut. And that was the end of my baseball career. So all the years I lived in Indiana, seen this many, many times, but never stopped until the last time we were here, like 8 years ago. So I thought we would stop again and film it this time. It's a little tiny prayer chapel. It's called the Taylor Prayer Chapel. Probably the world's smallest church. It smells like an old church.
Yeah, it does. Man, it's so much bigger inside, you know, than when you look at the outside.
Yeah, I'm gonna shut it, shut the door to keep the noise out. So they have a little registry here you can sign. Looks like the last time someone was here was 11/17. We'll sign it. Huh. Today is what, 11/21?
Let's see. Today is 11/22.
So this is Pimento Elementary, or what used to be Pimento Elementary, where I went to kindergarten through fourth grade. And they used to have two buildings here. There was a building here, a building here. And I'm trying to remember, I think this side had the gymnasium and the kindergarten through third grade maybe. This one was the higher grades. They used to have a playground out here with monkey bars. And they put white rock gravel underneath the monkey bars. And me being the klutz that I am, even back then, I fell off the monkey bars, cracked my head open, and was bleeding like a stuck pig, as they say here in Indiana. And I remember going from the monkey bars up through between the two buildings, trying to find the recess lady, you know, blood running down my forehead. And
you can see right here where the edge of the building was, brick.
Yeah, this is the one of the corners of the foundation, yeah. And it seems about right, because I remember there was a little bit of grass behind this building. As a matter of fact, the monkey bars or wherever it was up in here, when I fell and hit my head, I remember going around the building this way and to the back of the building to find the recess lady. And it's just amazing how the earth swallows this stuff back up and you barely can find any remnants of it here, you know? So now we're here at Hoosier Prairie Elementary, and this is where I went to fifth grade at when they closed Pimento down. basically, we were bused over here. This was a brand new school that they had just opened. And I'm trying to figure out where I went to sixth grade at, because I went to a Christian school for seventh grade. Then I transferred to Fairbanks Elementary for eighth grade and then on to high school. I don't know where I went to sixth grade at. It's kind of weird. This was such a modern school for its time. So still looks pretty different, I would say, the architecture of it.
So we are right now just turned onto Wabash Avenue in Terre Haute, downtown Terre Haute. This is the main drag. This is what we was teenagers. This is what we would call cruising the bash on a Friday and Saturday night. This used to be the heart of Terre Haute. Still looks like a lot of these are in business now. I remember coming down here, like right here was a Napa Auto Parts.
It's really cute.
And it was down in here.
Man, look at those trees, how yellow they are.
Look at the leaves on the ground.
I know. Wow. Pretty.
Oh, this is awesome. They got their Christmas lights up. Poles.
Yep. Oh, just ready to go.
We used to do our shopping when Mom would do her shopping down here. So this is Union Hospital here in Terre Haute, and this is where I was born. Literally, this is where I came into the world, was inside that hospital. It's also where my mom had her gallbladder surgery. It's also where I had an uncle pass away from an accident with fire. So there's a lot of history here at this hospital. Our family just found the mall that we didn't go to a lot, but it had an upstairs and a downstairs down below. So we're gonna get out and see if it still has the downstairs down below. But up here was a movie theater on this end, and it was where I seen Star Wars for the first time. Pretty unique mall, you know
it? Is.
Where you're inside, outside, kind of at the same time.
Uh-huh.
I guess it'd be good for cold weather.
Yeah, because most malls, if they're indoor like this, you wouldn't have all these windows.
It's basically like
you would have stores on both sides.
Right.
And then they do have the outdoor malls that are like this, but this would be all open.
Yeah, exactly.
So it's a combination of both together.
Right. So I'm here at Voorhees Park. This is where we used to come to go swimming a lot when we were kids. They had a public pool here. Now, apparently the public pool is inside. It's an aquatic center inside, so maybe keep it open year round. Looks like they have a skate park over there now. But the swimming pool was around in this area somewhere originally, and we used to swim here all the time. Our right, there's Indiana State Penitentiary, and it looks like it's grown a lot since we lived here. This is what I remember. But on down a little farther, it gets even bigger and more massive. And a little history lesson for you. If you don't know, this is where Timothy McVeigh was executed. Right here, Terre Haute U.S. Penitentiary. So here in Terre Haute, just got finished getting groceries at Walmart here. And I decided, hey, you know, my first ever lawn that I ever had, my first job and my first lawn in my lawn business, I wanted to go by and see if I could recognize it. And I totally did right off the bat. Even though they've added a driveway and like a carport on the side, no doubting that that is Mr. Sampson's house where I mowed as a 16 and 17 year old before moving to Florida. So who would have known, you know, 30 some odd years later,
that you spent your whole life doing the same job.
Exactly. But you know why I did this job? Because I had gotten a part-time job at Orange Julius when I was like 15, 16 years old. Found out that I was going to work X amount of hours and make X amount of dollars. And found out that I could work 2 hours mowing Mr. Sampson's lawn and make more money than I would take home from Orange Julius working a lot more hours. And that's kind of how I kind of stuck doing you know, the whole self-employed thing. All these years later.
Dave and Andrea have made it, and they're set up and they're hooked up.
I'm gonna have to tell him he can't park there.
We're here at Miram Bluff.
Oh boy, this is not gonna end well.